Tonight we're talking about Malaysia's competitiveness and why this is important for the future of our country. And I think the moderator has started off with a very important and pertinent question. What is competitiveness and why is it important for Malaysia? I think basically speaking, and to simplify it so that we can move on to some of the more detailed issues, competitiveness today is the most important buzzword in the global economy. It's the most important buzzword because every country wants to be competitive. So the root word is competition. Why do we need to compete and why do we need to be competitive? It's simply because in economics is the science of distributing scarce resources. In the world today, whatever resource you're talking about, whether it's capital, i.e. money, or petrol, natural resources, palm oil, whether you're talking about skilled labor, whether you're talking about unskilled labor, all these things are very finite resources, in a sense that they're not infinite, they're limited. So where these things go is a great and fundamental determinant factor on whether or not a country develops and succeeds. So every country wants to be competitive in the sense that they get all the investments, they get all the capital, they get all the skilled labor, they get all the patents, they get all the bright students, and they get all the bright professors to come to their country and teach. That's essentially what competition is about, what competitiveness is about. Now, what are the factors that determine competitiveness? Now, you want all this money, all this investments, all these very talented people to come to your country. For example, if you look at one of the world's biggest economy, the United States, a lot of people go to the United States. Money goes to the United States is one of the most indebted countries in the world simply because developing countries like China, with a lot of reserves, they send their money to the United States. The Middle East, they have a lot of petrodollars, they send their money to invest in the United States. Bright students all go to the United States, they go to Harvard of the world, the Princeton's, the Stanford's, the MIT's of the world, and end up staying there and working there. Now, what are the determinants of competitiveness? What do you have to be to attract these things in order to become competitive? Now, if you look at reports like the IMD report, if you look at reports like the WEF report, which the IMD report at least, which ranks Malaysia at number 10, in 2010, which is quite a high ranking for a developing country, some of the factors that determine competitiveness is the investment environment. As an investor, say you're a big investor, a multinational company like IBM or Samsung or Sony, and you want to invest in a country, what is the environment in which that country is as an investment destination? Do you feel comfortable? Can you do business there? Are they skilled labor there? Is the tax regime friendly? That is a determinant of whether or not money comes in terms of hard foreign direct investments, as in bricks and mortar, building factories. Other determinants of competitiveness: government policy. Is government policy friendly? Is the government business friendly? Is the government committed towards rooting out corruption, rooting out bureaucratic inefficiencies, streamlining the government, transforming the government from one that is rigid into one that is flexible and able to cater for the global marketplace? And there are many other issues, for example, education, skilled labor, language, and many other determining factors like infrastructure. So all these things taken together determines the country's competitiveness. And today, I know we're limited time, and there'll be more time to speak about this. I just want to say that I think Malaysia has done a good job. I think if you look at us, if you look at the IMD report, which is one of the best reports in terms of competitiveness, we went from 1918 in 2008, 2009, right up to number 10 in 2010. And this is not something that we made up, this is not something that I'm telling you, this is not something that Malaysia has written. This is by a think tank based in Switzerland that measures competitiveness based on objective criteria. And I think it's very important to know that in very, very difficult circumstances last year, where global investments just plummeted, there was a great financial crisis, we managed to emerge as a country that has been recognized as a very competitive country in terms of foreign investment and also in terms of economic growth. And I just want to add one thing. And I'm sure that you might raise this, or some of the other panelists might raise this. There was a recent report that came out, the UNCTAD report, the United Nations Conference of Trade and Development report, that said that FDI plunged last year by more than 60% and only registered $5 billion. True. But it's very, very competitive to get foreign direct investment today. In the past, Malaysia used to be the darling of foreign investors in the 90s, because we were the destination. Malaysia, together with Singapore, and China, India, Vietnam, countries which weren't open in the 90s, but today start from a lower base, so therefore they have more investment opportunities in Malaysia. So I'll leave it at that. Those are the key determinants of competitiveness, as I see it. And I think we've done well. We can do much better, but I think I'll leave it for my next intervention to tell you what the government is doing in order to increase competitiveness for Malaysia. Thank you very much.